Hey guys, how do you do? Welcome to the show Programming Wizards. Now for today, we're going to cover some basic threading using a background worker component. We're going to see how we can do heavy job in the background thread, while at the same time keeping our UI thread, our progress bar updated over here. This is it, background worker, of course, enables us to perform basic threading while at the same time keeping our UI thread updated. So this is what we're going to see. I click my start button. You can see our progress bar is getting updated right here alongside our percentage label over here. If I click cancel, of course, you have canceled. Now, if we click OK, it resets it to zero. If we start again, yes, it's going to update our progress bar right here. Okay. But at the same time, we simulate performing heavy job in the background thread. So this is it. We're completed right here. Then OK. And that's it. This is what we're going to see. Join me, get started. For you to do, of course, go ahead and create our project. To create our project, come right here, file new, then go to project. This is C#, it's a WinForm application, so go ahead, create it. Now once you've created it, let's come right here to our form designer, then design your form. Of course, I'm assuming you can simply drag whatever labels you want over right here. Okay, first start with this simple label. This is my group box. Okay, this is my group box right here. This is my progress bar. This is just a label, percentage label right here. And then I'm having two buttons, start and then of course cancel. Okay, after that one, the next thing, also you are having a background work over right here, so drag it over to your form right here. You can see it. Now once you've done so, click it, then all right, click it and then choose properties. Now for the properties, come over right here, properties. The first thing, this is our background worker, right here, is going to report progress, okay, to the UI thread. So set this one to true. By default, you'll find it false. Now set it to true. Then our worker supports cancellation. Yes, you shall be able to cancel our background job. Set this one to true. You can name your background worker whatever you like. Let's come to the event section. Then let's come over right here, override our do work. Then come override our progress change, and then of course override also our run worker completed. You guys have designed your form, and I'm also hoping you've added your background over right here component. Click it, come to a background worker right here, then come to the do work, double click it, double click progress change, double click run worker are completed. Then of course also your buttons. This is going to bring us to our source code. Now you can see we're having three methods that we are going to override. What are they? Okay, the first one, do work. This is where we're going to perform our job in the background stuff. You don't write any GUI because this is going to be a run called in the background thread. Okay, this method shall get invoked in our background thread. The second one, progress change. This method is going to help us update our UI. It gets invoked, of course, in our UI thread. So this is where we're going to be updating our progress bar. Run worker completed over here shall get called, of course, also in the UI thread. It's a method that shall be called when our job is over, okay? When the job, the background job we're doing is over. Now, once we've done that one, let's come over right here. Create a simple method right here that I'm calling simulate heavy job. This method right here, you can see what we're going to do. We're simply going to be sleeping or suspending our thread for 100 milliseconds. Of course, in a production application, you'll be doing something like maybe reading your disk or passing some data, or of course downloading some file. For us, we're simply going to be sleeping our thread for 100 milliseconds. Okay, let's also have a simple utility method right here that I'm calling display. This method right here is going to display for us the text. It takes a text and then of course it displays it in a message box. The next thing, let's come and start with our do work method. So here what we're going to be doing, of course, first let's have a loop. We're going to be counting from 0 to 100. Okay, now for each particular iteration, this is what we're going to do. We're using a background worker which supports cancellation. So the first thing we're going to use, check if there's a cancellation. Okay, if we have a cancellation pending, then we're going to cancel. How do we cancel? Well, we simply set our cancel property, of course, of our do work events class to true. We simply do that one. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then of course we go ahead, do our job, as we're going to be doing our job. Meanwhile, we shall be reporting our progress to our UI thread using the report progress method. That's it. That's our doing work method. Let's move over to our progress change. Our progress change. So what are you going to do? Of course, this is where we are performing updating our UI. To update our UI, this is what we're going to do. Okay, we simply come set our progress bar one value to e dot progress percentage. Take note right here, e is an object of our progress change event args. We shall also be updating, of course, our label. So we just cast this one, run worker completed. This is the method. This method shall be called, of course, when our job is over. Okay, so what should we do here? Well, what we're going to do is very simple. First, we're going to check if this thing has completed because it was cancelled. If this is the case, we simply display this one, then set progress value to 0, percentage label to 0. Otherwise, we come and say work completed successfully. Of course, that's it. That's it. The next thing, let's come and then, of course, implement this one. First, let's come to our true buttons. Okay. The first thing, let's come, we're going to start, of course, our background worker using the run worker async method. The next thing over here, we're going to cancel it by simply calling the cancel async method. This is going to cancel it for us, guys. That's it. Let's run our project, of course. So we come start right here. This is going to run for us our project. This is what we're getting. We click start. Our stuff, you can see right here, is running. Meanwhile, we're updating our progress bar. We're also updating, of course, our label, percentage label. Okay, if it reaches 100, you can see your work completed successfully. That's it. What if we come click start again? Okay, now the same round we cancel. You have canceled right here, you can see. Guys, that's it. That's our background worker. Okay, with our progress bar. I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, please subscribe so that you don't miss any of our tutorials. Also, we're going to attach the website for this particular tutorial, of course, in our website, camposha.com. So guys, get the source code, of course, in the link below. Take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.